Richard Torres, show me your medal really quick, fresh off the Tokyo Olympics. Congratulations, silver medalist. Big, big fight tonight. I want to get your assessment. Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury, what do you guys think?
It's a heavyweight fight, so I'm going to give you a heavyweight answer. It's almost like choosing between pie and cake. You know, they're both really good. I think if it goes past seven, I give it to Fury. If it goes anything less than that, I think Wilder's going to get a good shot in. I think both of those fighters are preparing a lot, and so it's going to be an amazing fight, and I'm just curious to watch.
I concur, right? You know, it's the same thing. I think that if it goes longer, it goes. Fury's got some good legs. He's got some good boxing skills. But, hey, it only takes one.
But, Richard, who do you want to win? And forget about being in a fight. As a fan, just watching.
You know, I think Tyson's a great guy, but I have to go with the USA guy. You know, I have to have the blood running through my veins, so I'm looking towards Wilder, man, because I want the USA to be on top.
Sounds father like son.
Okay, Usyk just beat Joshua. We all saw that fight, beautifully boxed. Beautiful. I thought he was gonna get robbed in England. Props to the people in England for not robbing him. What do you think about a rematch?
I think the rematch will go pretty similar. I think Joshua was a little gun shy on landing, on throwing that big punch. I'm not sure why. Maybe that'll change up a little bit. But ultimately, I mean, Usyk's thanks, his footwork, and it was brilliant what Usyk did. And so I think it'll probably transition in the second fight, and I think it'll continue to be like that.
What would be your dream fight? Which heavyweight would you love to fight? Like, Loma turned pro, two fights, fought for the title. So you turn pro, you do one fight, and then you're fighting.
I mean, I want to fight everybody. You know what I mean? One of the big guys I actually do want to fight is Joe Joyce. You know, I've seen him in the amateurs a little bit.
Olympic background, like yourself? He's only 11-0, 12-0, something like that, 13-0? Like.
Yeah, I think that'd be a good fight here down the road.
You think you can knock him out?
I'm excited to see what I can do against him. You know, so I really want to see that fight happen one day.
Okay, and my last question for your dad. Other parents watching this, and their kid is now 5 years old, 6 years old. What's the right way and the wrong way to raise your kid as a star athlete in boxing?
You know what? You can't push anybody too hard to do anything. You know, they're like a twig. You can't break them, okay? They're green and everything. You can bend them a little bit, but you got to know that point they're not breaking and stuff. And you just got to let them kind of have a choice in what they're doing and stuff. You direct them, you guide them, and you get them to the point where they start feeling comfortable with what they're doing and stuff. But you can't break them and stuff. You just got to ride them a little bit.
Be like bamboo. Bend, do not break. But that's it. So you say just let them enjoy it. Don't pressure them. And
anytime it becomes too much of a chore, young, you got to find something else. But give them a break. It's not all or nothing. You got to give them a lot of other sports to go into to create that overall general muscle coordination and stuff. But give them a lot of the outlets and stuff, not just one thing.
So when he won the medal, how did it make you feel?
It was spectacular. You know, it was spectacular and stuff. You know, when he was in that final, the final match, gold medal round and stuff, you know, how can I be ecstatic? You know, people wanted to come to my house. They wanted to have viewing parties. I didn't have any viewing parties. Just me, my wife, my daughter, and his dogs.
So, how many dogs you got?
We got one golden retriever right now.
Okay, very friendly.
Yeah, we've got another golden, but it was great and stuff, you know. I'm not an emotional guy, but yeah, you got to get some tears in there, you know.
Listen. If they weren't there when you put in the work, don't be there when it's time to celebrate.
There you go.
All right.
They brought you their dance.
Richard Torres, one more time, where they follow you?
You can follow me on Instagram at The Richard Torres. That's T-H-E-E, Shakespearean. That's how I roll. The Richard Torres on Instagram.
And THC Boxing.
THC Boxing. Make sure to follow them. Stay tuned. Big things coming in the pros. PhilliesNewsReport.com. I'm Zekbach reporting.